Dear Heavenly Father, we come to you, God, asking, soliciting your presence, Lord. Humbly coming to you, God, asking, God, that you would bless us, touch, and agree right now, Heavenly Father. Your word says that if any two on earth touch and agree, God, that you loose them, Heavenly Father. Touch and agree for your spirit. Speak to all of us, God. Without you, Father, we would be lost. We need you, God. Can't make without you. And save a soul today, God, in the name of Christ Jesus. Enemy, we come against you. We ask you, God, for peace. Peace in the room, God, peace of mind, that our minds will be stayed on you as your word before, God. Do not allow the enemy to take our mind across town, God, in the basement and around the corner. What they're going to do after church, bless us, God, in the name of Christ Jesus. Feed us, we your sheep, God. Amen. Amen. I ask those of you, I pray that you brought your Bible to church today. I couldn't imagine a police officer going to the station without his gun. It'd be hard for the head nurse to tell the surgeon she forgot her, I believe it's called, that's a scope. How do you pronounce that? I don't believe Bishop will go to the job site without his hammer and his tools. And we love to sing the song, I'm a soldier in the army of the Lord. How can you go to war without your gun? The Bible says, Hebrew 13, chapter 13. We're going to start at the first verse. Let us stand for the reading of the Word of God. The book of Hebrew. Starting at the first verse, and we're going to go down to 5. It says, let brotherly love continue. Be not forgetful to entertain strangers. For thereby some have entertained angels unaware. Remember them that are in bond, as bond with them, and them which suffer adversity, as being yourselves also in the body. Marriage is honorable in all, and the big undefiled. But whoremongers and adulterers, God will judge that your conversation be without covenants. Be content with such things they have, for he has said, I will never leave thee nor forsake thee. You may be seated. I'm going to attempt. Thank you so much. Thank you. I'm going to take my subject today. Just going to be different for some of you. You put that there, I promise, I'm instead of I'm going to try to take my subject today from verse 2. This is going to be different for some of us. But it says, be not forgetful to entertain strangers. For thereby some have entertained angels unaware. Be not forgetful. We're going to start here because some of us, even though we bear the title, I'm saved and sanctified, I'm Holy Ghost filled, I'm fire baptized, I'm running for my life, and running for Jesus, we rude.
Amen.
It's a rude saints. And then I'm not saying you are not saints.
Right, right.
Because I believe my brother Paul said they were Christians, but they were yet carnal. But yet they were Christians.
Amen. Amen.
So there are some rude saints. Rude. No kindness in their heart. I like how Jesus put it. He talked about the wheat and the tare. Jesus said at the beginning stages, the wheat looked just like the tare. You couldn't tell them apart. So basically, what he was saying was that you got some Christians in their baby stage look like sinners.
All right.
In the beginning stages, they look just like sinners. And it's wild when you can't tell the difference between a sinner and a saint. But just so happened, that's not what we're preaching about today. But I kind of want to get you to understand why. And I tried to share this at United House of God. The easiest way not to misinterpret a scripture is to know who's talking, who they're talking to, and why did they just say what they just said. So right here, it says, now listen, it says, be not forgetful. Don't forget. Because I know you have a job. I know you have to get up in the morning. You have to go to work because Niagara Mohawk do not accept. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. You can't speak in tongues. And they're going to take that as payment for your light bill. So he said, don't forget it in the midst of all the other things that you have to do. You have wives, listen, cook dinner for your husband.
Amen, amen.
He said, don't forget to take care of your husband. Don't forget to take care of your children. But in the midst of you doing all the things you have to do, be mindful. That God works. Is my young people in the house? Now, be mindful of this. We serve a God who operates a particular way. And the problem is, some of us do not know how the God that we serve operates.
Amen.
And one of those reasons, again, you don't go to Sunday school.
Amen.
You don't go to Bible study.
Amen.
You don't. We have a lot of Sunday saints. And I'm going to explain to you what a Sunday saint is. A Sunday saint is a saint that only reads their Bible. Well, whoever is speaking says, could you open up your Bible to the book of Hebrews chapter 13? That's the only time you open up the Word. So that is one of the reasons why some of you will not understand this message. Not because I haven't studied to deliver it right to you. You haven't done your part. To understand when the preacher preached, what are they talking about? Some people on Sunday church was a bomb, and some people, it was boring because you don't study, so you don't know what we're talking about. People say God's so good, you don't know God good because you haven't put God to the test. Because he says in the book of Malachi, try me and see.
Come on now.
If I'm a liar. So, now listen. In the Old Testament, we still on verse 2. In the Old Testament, it talks about people worshiping gods. For those of you who take me for granted, somebody go to Bible study, somebody go to Sunday school, and somebody study, it talks about Baal, B-A-A-L. It talks about, the name reads Lord of the Flies, or Lord of He That Flies.
All right. Okay.
So it happened, Satan gets kicked out of heaven. When Satan gets kicked out of heaven, he's cast down to the earth. Now he becomes a falling angel. He still can fly.
All right.
He still can fly. But he's no longer on the sky side.
All right.
And so what happens is, remember in the book of Genesis chapter 3, and the serpent that was in the tree began to speak to Eve.
Okay.
She speaks to Eve and says, did God truly say? And so that same serpent, as time goes on, people call him in the garden the serpent, but as time goes on, people began to call him something different.
All right.
And so the reason they called him Baal, because he was the Lord of the Flies, they was just worshiping a deity that flew.
Amen.
Now, as time went on, years go by, he meets a different group of people, and the group changes and begin to call him Beelzebub.
All right.
And the reason the Beelzebub part was But because
everybody resting on their feet. Father, we thank you for the word one more time. Thank you for the fellowship. And Lord, we pray now, even in the sanctuary, for the festivities of the banquet hall. We pray that you would bless the food that we're about to receive. Allow it to nourish our bodies so that we can continue to do kingdom work. Touch and bless, Lord God, our brother and our sister. It's Men and Women's Day, so we celebrate both genders fully, recognizing, Lord God, that you have made us distinctly different, but we are indeed your creation. And we bless you and we give you praise today as we partake of this wonderful meal. Bless those that have prepared it. We pray a special blessing upon those that are working in the fellowship hall. Provide for them, Lord God, in a special way. We thank you and we give you glory. And we pray this prayer in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Now let the words of my mouth, the meditations of my heart, be acceptable in thy sight. O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. Give somebody a great big hug before you dismiss. And let them know I love the Lord. I love the church, and I love you too.